just go that. Death Shepherds are the ones we need to concentrate on because they just keep bringing them back. So I think these are the ones we need to really concentrate on.
Go to the bathroom. For 5 fucking minutes. Right after going live. Come back, goddamn live ain't working. I don't even remember wearing the Sam Hill I'm at. Oh yeah, there's dude behind me I wanna go deal with. There he is. Hitch and posts are usually up near a door. Yeah, there we go.
You alright, Rin?
I guess. I'm still alive.
Cheery kind of fella, ain't you?
Haven't got much to be cheerful about.
Don't guess I do neither.
I came here to make my fortune. I got a job so I could marry my beloved. She says she is still waiting for me, but I will never get out from here. I will never see Shanghai again. I'll live and die in the dust.
Why not?
I'm indentured. We all are. We're little more than slaves.
Slaves?
They ain't slaves, gringo. Not slaves at all. They just have to do a month's work to get a month's pay. Don't you, sir?
Yes, sir.
Let this man go free.
This man signed a contract. If the law don't respect contracts, the law don't respect nothing. Ain't that right, sir?
Come on, give this man his freedom.
This man owes me $10,000 if he breaks his contract. It's written down clear as day.
Let him go.
I'll tell you what, gringo, cowboy, get me, I don't know, get me a white stallion like a real cowboy rides, And this dog is yours to keep.
Dude wants a stallion white. Not real sure where to go for that. Pokemon in chat. So, showing up here in this back corner.
Sister?
Yes, sir. Can I help you?
I was looking for a girl by the name of Eva, I think. Wanted to see if she was doing okay.
Are you one of her special things?
No, I just helped her.
Oh.
She said she was coming in here.
Oh, she came and she went. A man came for her. Turned out maybe he was her calling after all.
Okay. Thank you, sister.
Oh, I think they said they were going to El Sepulcro. But who knows? She wasn't much of one for the truth.
Watch yourself, miss.
Okay, yep. This is the way out.
Doing, amigo?
Nothing.
Why'd you kill her?
I didn't kill her. I wouldn't do a thing like that. Sure, I hit her, but...
Why'd you kill her? And why are you digging her up?
What business is it of yours, huh? Oh. Still want to lay with her? Huh?
You sold her. You let her go.
No, no, no. A good whore never leaves, man.
Get my money back now or after I've killed you?
It's just a goddamn whore, man. A goddamn filthy whore.
As you say, she was just a whore.
Okay.
Now come on.
Well, this is gonna be fun. At least make my money back off this asshole. Hungarian half-breed, huh? Alright. First, let's go here. I need to do that anyway. Okay. Not gonna let me do whatever that was then. Come over here. And do this. I need to okay.
market. You steal one of the wagons, I give you good money.
All right. You best be ready to pay up.
Wild Pokemon in chat. Get those Pokeballs out. Now time to go see about breaking in a new horse. Gotta be a way to get down there.
break this quick. This is a message. You eat.
This is dirty. Come on, let's get this over with.
Guess we can save that poor guy. Fucking bolt action just obliterates him. I don't get a chance to get anything out of him. Looks like there's no Pokemon in chat.
still.
Well, let's see about going to pay off my bounty. I need to be worried about fucking bounty hunters in here. Thank you. Now we're going to see if I can't find me a white stallion. Damn it. That did not work out quite the way I wanted it to. Alright, so that adds a new horse to my stable. Thing. God damn it.
Thanks a lot.
No, I can't yet. Thought there might be something to that. Apparently not. Pokemon in chat.
There we go. That's one.
I mean, if he's just going to stand there looking over the corpse, I don't see any reason why I shouldn't just go ahead and grab the meat and shit off of it. No, buddy. Alright, that may have just given me what I needed. We'll have to wait and see. If I can avoid fucking this up this time.
More than you now.
Looks like the camp's been taken out. Oh, I see what they want me to do now. All right. Like, there was no one fucking alive here. Why is it still telling me to do stuff?
Excellent work! Now go speak to the general! He will want to thank you personally!
Now I know what they wanted. Yo, what's up, Danny?
Sign up my gratitude. Now we must leave.
Escalada. I think I broke the stallion that they wanted me to break. Which, if I did, will give me access to the Hungarian half-breed purchase. Which will allow me to complete at least a section of the side quest I'm working on. Shops aren't going to be open yet. Got it. Excellent. While that's coming for me, where was it that I needed to take that? Wasn't there there it is. Oh shit, I missed Jigglypuff. Yo, Husky, what up? Chillin'. Just trying to finish off at least part of a new side mission I just picked up. Took me a hot minute to find me a horse of the right coloration. Thank you, Danny boy. Once I found her, just a matter of breaking her, then going to buy the right breed from the store, and then taking said breed to the quest location. And turn shit in. Let's go. And along the way, doing stuff like this just to gain fame points and. Okay, purchase was expensive though. $750. I'm glad that I've been saving up money. I hadn't been, you know, needing to spend it on a whole lot, so I had about $2,000 to make the purchase. Fucking problem is that going to make this purchase took me clear the other side of the fucking map. So turn in is gonna take me a couple of minutes. And that's full bore racing on the horse to get my fat ass to where I gotta go. Now that's done. I have a bounty mission available if someone wants to spend the points to make me go do it. Spend some channel points, make me go play cards or something. Gamble. Or I'll just continue on and do this main mission. Madam, how you doing there, partner? Causing yourself any trouble today? I reckon I'm doing all right, more or less. Remember, folks, there are redeems that I've put in place specifically for this game's play. Also, remember my viewer reward system and my giveaways. Pay attention to the, to the bot. Bot will give you the information, more or less. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, you're free to voice them. Depending on what it is, I may or may not take it under consideration. But I am always open to a little bit of, feedback or new ideas or, you know, anything of that nature. And everybody in my channel gets a shout out there, Matt. Everybody gets one. If I know you're here and I know you're human, you get a shout out. Well, that's a hell of a scene to walk into, isn't it?
And I'm a rapper, huh?
What would your most loyal follower, Luisa, say about that?
Who?
Luisa. The girl from Campo Morada?
Alright. A gentleman never tells, but she was a most wonderful... I just say she was incredible. Yes. Let me tell you something. I strongly recommend her. You take.
Oh, hell no. I've been playing this off and on since... Like,
my wife?
The early 2000s or so?
They believe every word a fellow says. So naive. He's really quite charming.
Nah, this ain't my first go around in this.
I love them. They have such purity.
Are you gonna marry her?
Marry a peasant? My dear boy, don't be absurd. I'm going to be the next president of Mexico. My wife.
I do too.
Kings, other great men, the very thought that I would marry some peasant girl with a tight cut and the hands of a farmer. Well, I really don't think so. My mother, good luck with it, with turning her grave.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. But come on, let's run. I've got an amazing present for you, my brother, huh? Yes? The man you seek. Together, we will bring them to justice. Let's go.
A huge fan of these games. You're not new to my chat, are you?
Let's go, John. Today we will both have victory. Let's ride, my brother.
Try to remember if this is your first time in here or not. You been in here since I started doing viewer redemptions and the giveaways?
My men will launch a ruse attack on the side entrance to the fort. Meanwhile, you, my American friend, will drive this wagon at the front gate and jump off with your clothes. He's been packed with 5 crates of TNT.
That sounds crazy. How long's the fuse?
Yes, like I say, fun times. It's plenty long enough, I think. I see you in there, amigo. Go on, John. You can do this.
A death stream? I don't know exactly what the hell you're talking about.
now before he escapes, my friend! You fight like a chica!
Come on, pop up. There you go. You dumb bastards. Okay. It's like, what you talking about, Death Stream? I have that same issue.
Took your time, no? Come on, you're not gonna shoot your own brother, are you? We was family.
Yeah, we were. Then you and Dutch went crazy and family didn't mean so much.
So, now you do the government's work.
And what do? You just work for a different government.
Come on, brother. I think we should go our separate ways, huh?
What you and Dutch did was wrong. And the way you left me was wrong. Now, I hate to judge, but as it turns out, it's you or me. The way I see it, might as well be you.
We thought you was dead, brother. I promise. I'm telling the truth. Besides, I can give you beat. In Dutch. Dutch is in Colombia. I can take you straight to him. Hmm?
You left me to die? To save your own skin, and now you expect me to care about you?
You got it all wrong, brother. I've always loved you. Even now.
Go back to your farm, bro! Come for you! Go make me kill you, Javier! Come on!
You don't have the heart to kill me!
Give it up, Javier! I'm taking you in, my brother! I'll let the others judge.
I know!
Where's Bill?
I don't
Where's
know.
Bill, you son of a bitch? You think I won't kill you, brother?
He ain't here, brother. He's with Agenda. It's a little late for revenge, John.
I ain't here to kill you, Javier. This is just business. Come on.
Come on, amigo. Abigail wouldn't want this.
Abigail would have killed you already. She always thought you was a creep.
He managed to get a little bit of a fair distance away, though, didn't he? And I didn't even have my own damn horse. I had to ride some in-game nag. Still caught his ass, though. Thought about killing him.
Locked up for a hell of a long time. Unless they choose to hang me.
Understand what happened. It wasn't like you thought it was.
Whatever you say, old friend.
Wrong button.
It was Deal, not me.
Yeah, and he's next.
Put him in the cell for now, though.
Oh, shit. Don't be sure about what you're doing, brother. You saw me out. Didn't that life we had mean nothing to you? One day, I promise you, you're gonna regret this.
One day's about all you got left.
I hope you and your wife and children rot in hell.
You know, that life we lived is over. And when we was living it, it didn't mean nothing anyway. It was just an excuse, and we all knew.
What I knew is that you was always a puto. And you're still a puto.
Marston, come with me. The army sent reinforcements. Go.
Yeah, go with your puto.
The army is coming. Get up there and man that cannon.
Oh, I see where they want me to go. I mean, if you play RDR2, Which is technically this game's prequel game. Kind of bears that theory out. Alright, I gotta pause this for a minute. I need to go to the bathroom, grab some coffee. I'll be back in a minute. Yeah, but see, that's kind of the thing, though, with RDR2, with the story that goes with it and everything, is a lot of the guys, like, that little clique that was basically Dutch's inner circle, they were in it for what they considered glory and easy gains. That's all they gave a shit about. They didn't care about, you know, the things Dutch was preaching at the time or anything like that. They were in it to get themselves ahead. That's all they cared about. It's all about the money. Like, we find that out in the story. Morgan and Marston were kind of different folks. Now, like, there's basically, there's two ways Morgan could go in RDR2. You can either have him come out as the good guy, or he could be an evil asshole like Dutch and Javier and the rest of them. Marston, on the other hand, was never really suited for that life. Marston was all about the ideals that Dutch preached. So was most of the people that were considered members of the game the gang throughout that game. They were in it because they thought Dutch was going to help lead them to a better life. They thought Dutch was going to help try to root out that systemic corruption that was there and make things better until those long-held down psychoses that Dutch held started coming to the forefront, and he became, I would diagnose Dutch as severely manic depressant, possibly bipolar, and very possibly schizophrenic, as well as very much ADD and ADHD. I mean, the man was just not right in the head. And anybody that's played Red Dead and Red Dead 2 that doesn't get that man ain't, you know, that boy ain't right upstairs, that he ain't all proper hooked up, they don't understand that man. And they don't understand the storyline for these here games. Like, Dutch, when he created that gang, when he created that quote-unquote family, that boy was already a couple sheets to the wind when it came to being sane or not sane. He was already, a little bit out there. I mean, if you listen to what the man says in the early parts of the game when you first start playing, you go through that first, like, I'd say about the first quarter of it. If you listen to what the boy preaches and how he talks, that boy was gone, a little bit gone already. And then, you know, all the subsequent, you know, both successes and failures that Dutch and company encounter throughout the course of the game, it all culminates when they get on that ship and then they end up down on that Caribbean island. I can't remember which one. It's been a while since I played. You know, they get the shit happens, the ship gets wrecked, they end up on that island down in the Caribbean or some shit, and they're working on finding a way back here to the States. As, you know, as it stood in that era of American history. That's when I think Dutch well and truly fucking fully snapped. Like, he was already like 95, maybe 98% of the way there by those events in the game. But it was when those events happened that I think Dutch just lost it completely. That last 2-5% sanity that he was left holding on to, that Marston and Morgan kind of helped him hold on to a little bit, because they did, they really did. He lost it right then and there. And I feel sorry for Dutch. I do. I pity Dutch in a lot of ways, because Dutch was a victim more than anything else. Dutch was a victim. He wasn't really a bad dude. He wasn't truly a bad guy.
Mr. Marston, fancy seeing you down here.
He was a victim of himself and the world in which he grew up.
Javier here gets to see how far the hand of justice can reach.
Now, again, that's my personal take on it, and this is coming from a fellow who happens to be mentally disabled himself.
We need you to find Williamson, then head to Blackwater as quick as you can. We have reason to believe that...
You know, so I kind of know a thing or two about mental illness and psychosis and all that, given how I grew up and all that. And Dutch was very much a victim. Ooh, trophy, Sons of Mexico. It's completed the gates of El Presidio. But yeah, like Dutch was very much a victim of essentially the old West, I guess be the best way to put it. But that doesn't necessarily mean that he wasn't entirely responsible, because he was. He absolutely was. But he was also responsible absolutely for the events he put into play later on down the line. He's responsible ultimately for what happens with Marston and his family. The one final thing that could bring, I think, Dutch back from the brink, or for being over that brink. And he is responsible for what happens to Bill Morgan. 100%. But all that said, he's still a victim. Absolutely.
Zap, what are you doing?
Hello, Master.
What are you doing here? You left El Matadero weeks ago.
Well, I missed the train.
What are you talking about?
I'm leaving. Tomorrow, honestly.
What about your beloved?
She said she would wait. Honestly, I'm quitting tomorrow. And leaving.
Quitting?
I didn't say that. But I'm fine. I'm fine. She's my beloved.
I love it.
What the hell was all that about?
Can I have this?
Let's go.
Oh, let's see. Yeah, there it is. That's the second fucking time today, god damn it. Like I was saying though, like, by the time you get about halfway through Red Dead 2, those camps start getting huge. I mean, you get a whole bunch of new folks brought in, you know, like a massive influx of people into the camp. You know, you end up having like thousands of dollars on hand at any given point in time. Like, in many ways, you really do become, as a member of the gang, a victim of your own success. Kind of what I would call, like, a little bit of the Robin Hood syndrome. Wonder I wasn't hurting them too much. Didn't have the right damn rifle on. Gonna fucking shoot at me. Make sure that when you do, you kill me. You got anything interesting, friend? I wasn't shooting at your dumb ass.
This will fetch a good price.
Thank you. I'm only taking some time to do this today because I'm still working on a requirement for an outfit in a game. It requires me to collect $200 worth of flowers. There's the hitching post. Why are there fucking dead bodies all over the goddamn place here? What the hell is going on? I can go search that place here in a minute. Still gotta find snakes. Working on some of that. Holy shit, Scooby-Doo, I haven't seen you in here in a while, man. How you doing? And Mr. Grantland, how are you? Call of Duty and NBA 2K22.
Kong is a drunk! If I were you, I would pull that trigger!
Put the gun down, Americano!
Ya! Ya, matalo!
Dejen mi hombre!
Mierda!
Huh? Ay, Dios mío!
Santa Maria!
Okay, but we fight like men, not like dogs.
You go after the prisoners. Shoot the doors! They will open! Bravo! Thank you, compadre! I will fight next to you!
Muchas gracias! Muchas gracias!
¿Quieres luchar o besarme, cabrón?
God damn it, move.
lot of them.
All right, that Gatling cannon's gonna be a problem. Keep forgetting I got this damn sniper. Making something out of this, fuck you. Considering I did most of the work, I want the goddamn spoils. Well, that made that easy.
What you got on, man?
That was an easy about $200.
Come on, we can still get to my stagecoach.
Go there, I'll cover you.
It's Agente Williamson. Come on, go.
Vámonos, date prisa, cabrón.
Come on, Joe. Let's get you the horses. Give up, Williamson!
Shit! You almost got me!
Whoa! Whoa! Faster!
pendejo! Get up, dummy! And get out of the wagon! Apúrate!
I'm coming out! Don't shoot!
Here! Take Williamson. Just let me live. I will leave the country, I promise.
Yeah, sure he will.
You always was weak-minded.
You're the one who let Dutch drive you insane!
Allende is dead! Mexico is mine!
My people are free, and it is all thanks to you, John.
And to the people who laid down their lives. People like Luisa.
Oh, yes. She was very brave. She will be missed. Who was she?
Your peasant girl wife-to-be?
Oh, yes, of course. She will have a day named after her. Laura's day!
Luisa.
What? Oh, yes, I knew Laura as well. Magnificent girl. Like riding a pompous bull, it was, amigo. You never saw anything like it. Anyway, enough about sport. Let's get back to politics. I trust you will join us in riding on the Capitol.
I'd love to, but with Williamson dead, my jailers need me back in Blackwater.
Hey, que así? ¿Cuánten sí? Well, I must say, I'll miss you, John Marston.
I doubt you'll even remember me, Abraham, but it's been an experience. Revolution. If you win power, remember why you won it.
Travel safely, amigo. Vamos.
Trophy earned. No more fancy words. I completed an appointed time. Okay. One feature about RDR2 I like a little bit better is that when you have clumps of shit to sell, it lets you like do a thing that says, hey, sell all this at one shot. Pokemon in chat, folks. Get your Pokeballs out.
How you doing, Senor Marco?
encuentro este cabrón con mi mujer, voy a romper su cara. My weapons are the mejores en escalera. Señor, this is not bad at all.
I also like that they added grades in RDR2 to what you sell for like skins and meat and shit. And that, you know, you were kind of forced to sell meat pretty quick because otherwise it would spoil on you. There goes Danny, just catching all the Pokemon again. More than a fistful, trophy earned. I earned over $10,000. All told, while playing. I've killed and skinned 3 snakes. Well over 30 wolves at this point. Like in RDR2, I would not be allowed to carry that much goddamn meat on me for that goddamn long without that meat going bad. I'd either have to sell it, eat it, or get rid of it.
How you doing, Señor Marco?
Oh, they do let you do mass quantity. Awesome.
Hola, Señor Marco.
That's what I want.
Adelante.
hope he stops doing that.
What the hell was I being shot for? Hey, Gingerbeard, what's up? How's that asshole not there?
Come on. I wish to do where everyone see me kill you, you know?
Okay, that was dumb. There's no way I should have fucking died there. Yeah, everything's all right. Just a couple things in this just not making a great deal of sense. Son of a bitch, I'm gonna have to resell all that. God damn it. I hope you guys for some unknowable fucking reason. I got goddamn shot. For doing nothing.
Excuse me. Take your time, sir. business of it, like I was born yesterday.
Off this way.
Only I'd hired you instead.
Mr. McKenna, what are you doing here? Thought you were running a film company.
Oh, Marston, how the fate...
GLHF? I'm afraid I don't comprehend that there, Dredd.
The hubris.
How you doing?
Hubris.
It gets the best of us.
I've lost everything. Every last dime I invested in that...
Oh, okay. Well, I am. This is Red Dead Redemption, after all. It's one of my favorite all-time games.
...fell in love with the cameraman and ran off to Canada. Damn you, the gods of bad weather! And the hearts of vain men. Guess I'll have to go make dreams elsewhere.
Good luck.
Oh, I reckon I'm all right. Okay. So that's the only one I got left then.
It's a beautiful spot.
Sure. What are you doing here?
My accounts. I'm an accountant.
Is that so?
In a way.
What's your name?
You know, it's the darndest thing. I can't remember.
Tell me your damn name and where you know me from.
Well, I know you're from Mexico. I know you're from back out west. Hell, I know you from all over.
Yeah, Pokemon in chat. Get your Pokeballs out.
For my actions.
Oh, but you will. You will be responsible.
This is a fine spot. See you around, cowboy. Damn you!
Yes, many have.
Aw, the Pokemon got away, folks.
Excuse me, miss. Something wrong?
Does it look like something's wrong?
Well, you look kind of upset about something.
Perhaps you don't understand what it's like to be disgraced as a woman. To have people gossip about you and turn from you in disgust day after day.
People can be real unkind, that's for sure.
I'm Clara. I used to be a nanny for a family here in Blackwater. The father was always so charming. And I, fool that I was, fell for him. Mrs. Thornton, his wife, kicked me out on the street as soon as I started showing. Mr. Thornton turned to drink. Not even a farewell. Or a dollar. I have nothing. They will surely take my baby from me. Perhaps you could find the dissolute bastard. Get even a few dollars for me and my baby to find a home. I'd be so grateful, sir.
I'll see what I can do.
Now I'm an alimony collector? Of sorts, or something along them. Man, they really do have you doing all kinds of strange side quests in this game.
Excuse me. You know a girl named Clara?
What's that? Is she one of the waitresses around here?
No, she was a servant at your house.
The only servant we had was that wee darky girl, Sarah. She left to join the people up north.
Or so she could set up a modest household for her and the child.
Did you put your mind, laddie, or are you just a common criminal? A nerve, are you?
Hey, Clara.
Hello, mister.
Got you some money.
Oh, you are very kind. Very kind. And how's Harold? How's my Harold?
Didn't go so well. I'm afraid he's dead.
Dead?
Unfortunately so.
I must go to his grave.
Afraid I don't know where that is.
Oh, he'll be buried in the cemetery at the family plot. Now hurry, I can make it to his funeral.
Will people never fucking change? To be honest, I don't believe that's the truth. I fully believe humanity is capable of a massive amount of change. If and we put our minds to it. Get out of the way, dude. Damn. It's not gonna be time yet. Damn it, what is going on with my fucking internet today?
Day's work for an honest day's pay.
Then looks can be deceiving, pal.
Perfect. As honesty is in my business, the worst policy. I work for a well-respected governor, Nate Johns.
That makes sense.
Now, there is a certain individual spreading nasty rumors about Mr. Johns. I'd like you to put a stop to this vile gossip.
Suppose I can handle that? For the right price?
Now, this individual's had the misfortune to be photographed enjoying some rather inappropriate company. Been seen with a local bull. Take these photographs to him. After you take care of business, return to me and I'll pay
up. Pokemon in chat, folks.
You're doing great things for your state, dear friend. You should be.
Johns.
Nate Johns? Why, that no good lying backstabbing bastard. I'd like to see him horsewhipped. Why you ask, friend?
Need to make sure I had the right man. Would you care to take a quick look at a couple photographs of you coming out of a fine place with not much repute?
As I was saying, before I was so rudely interrupted. Nate Johns is a fine, fine man and an even better governor. And I consider it an honor to call him my friend.
Hey, Dread Optimus caught himself far-fetched. Go. I need to go to the bathroom right quick and then hurry and grab some coffee. I'll be right back. Yes. swear if I have another goddamn tech issue on this today, I'm just not gonna continue. That was literally like the third in 3 hours. Third or fourth tech issue. Where I had to stop the goddamn stream because either it dropped or I'm getting this notification on my system. Your internet's not good enough. Fuck you, bitch. So for the explosive rifle, I need $5,000.
Thank you.
that next step in the journey. Pokemon and chat.
107. 109.
Edgar Ross.
113. Upstairs on the right. 114. 115.
16. Mr. Marston, so glad to see you. How was your journey?
Where's my wife and son?
Being well looked after. Well,
I want to see him.
Mr. Ross wants to speak with you. We've had some important developments.
You want me to take out a gun and blow a fucking hole in your head right here? Right now? You want that?
Mr. Marston.
You want that?
Mr. Marston, I ask you to calm down.
Why? Why? I did what you asked. I got you Williamson and Escuela. It's over. Stop playing games with me.
No one's playing games with you, Mr. Marston. But if we were to play some games, there'd be some interesting ones we could play. Like hanging you for murder. Or confiscating all your property. Like that little farm of yours. Or having you put in an electric chair. Those are the sort of games we could play. But we choose to play a different game. So calm down and play along with us.
Where's my wife?
You don't forget, but I hear it's very nice this time of year. Mr. Marston, please, I've never insulted your meager intelligence. Do not insult mine. We've done this little deal for your freedom in exchange for all your men in your old gang. You gave us Williamson and Escuela. We still don't have Vanderman, but now we know where he is.
Then go and shoot him.
No, sir. I want you to shoot him for me. And then I'll let you be. The last thing I want to do is make martyrs of these people. He could be killed by some petty squab or by another lowlife.
We believe Vanderlyn is holed up with a group of renegades near the wreck of the Serendipity Riverboat.
Another group of renegades. Obviously, the first group, your group, has, shall we say, been disbanded. Anyway, Mr. Ford and Mr. Marston, shall we go? Oh, Mr. Marston, your wife and son are doing well. Let's both try to ensure they're safe.
Did you put a seashell in my chop, Dread? You fucking weirdo.
Oh, Mr. Marston, one more thing. This is for you.
You're too kind.
See, I have nothing but your best interest at heart.
Let's hope it doesn't go off by mistake.
343.
I have a patent for that, sir. This is an outrage. Ah, Mr. Marston. You're alive.
Hello, Wes Dickens. I thought you were headed to Peking.
So did I. So did I. It's a long story. But now it seems I'm being put under arrest and charged with narcotic possession or some other such nonsense.
Ross, have him release this man.
Why?
Because he's a harmless old fraud, the kind of man that built this country. And because he helped me get Williamson.
Did you hear that, officer? The man's a hero. Let him go. Come on, Marston. Moral degeneracy waits for no man. Let's hurry along.
344. 5. 6. 8. Hunt says no weapons. Hunt says no weapons.
Head for the wreck of the Serendipity, Mr. Ford.
Yeah, now this is gonna get fun.
It's not far now. The old Serendipity.
Alright,
Serendipity Wreck has been used as an occasional criminal hideout for years. We were informed that Vanderlyn and his gang are making camp. We'll stop on the cliff above, and you and Agent Fordham will go on foot. I'll stay with the vehicle and keep watch.
And you'll do as I say, Marston. Don't try anything stupid.
Oh, I think he knows what's at stake. Don't you, Mr. Marston?
Let's find Dutch and finish this.
Right, let's go, Mr. Marston. Keep quiet and stay close.
Yes, sir.
Vanderloo is the priority. You go in, take it down, get the hell out of here. Quick and clean.
You leave Dutch to me. We don't want you getting that suit dirty.
If you step out of line, even once, I hope you're aware of the consequences. Seems a little quiet, don't you think?
You tell me.
Maybe Dutch caught wind of things. That informant better not have been lying to us. Keep your eyes open.
They are open. I don't see nothing.
It doesn't feel right. This place is usually teeming. Did you hear that? Go see what's happening. I'll wait here. Coming from somewhere.
There we go.
Informant. Nuss, what the hell's going on here? It's a trap. Shit, Marston, you'll have to carry this man. I don't think he can walk. Come on, we need to get him to...
You fellas couldn't even
see
you with your hat.
Cover him.
There's a bastard.
last chance to surrender.
That was easy.
Who's this? What in God's name is going on? Marston, lift this fellow into the back seat. Put him in the car so we can get out of here. Let's go. There might be more of them.
Christ alive! What the hell happened down there?
It was a trap. They were waiting for us.
And who is this savage? A prisoner?
This is the informant, sir.
Do you speak English?
Yes, he does, sir. He's the informant, Nostos.
Don't get snarky with me, Fordham.
We found him tied up on the boat, then they jumped us.
Nice of you to help us out. Hell of a plan sending in two men to take on an entire gang of outlaws. Especially when one of them's an office clerk. Or social secretary or some
stuff. Just shut your mouth!
Dude, you didn't shoot nobody! I like shot everybody, get us the hell out of there! Fuck you! Guy's such a dick! Jesus.
Thank you. can't see any more of them. Fordham, are we ready?
Yes, sir, I think so.
Come on, let's get back to Blackwater.
Damn, that was close.
We're lucky to be alive.
Oh, Pokemon in chat. Poochyena this time, by the look of her.
The ending to Professor McDougal. See what he can get out of him.
Good idea, sir.
I just can't communicate with them. Here we are. Thank God for that.
So, this is the office of an anthropologist named McDougal. He was thrown out of Yale for degeneracy.
We should tell you something.
Indeed. But he's been helping us deal with the natives in this area.
They see him and they presume we're all idiot academics.
Huh? Give me a hand here, Marston.
Ah, Mr. Ross, Mr. Fordham? Good day, good day. What on earth's going on here?
Kid got shot in the leg. Beat up pretty good.
We'll send a doctor. Now, McDougal, we need information from this fellow about Dutch Vanderland. Can you see what you can find out for us?
Do my best, sir.
Make sure you do.
Professor McDougal has been a good friend of the U.S. government, Mr. Marston, just like you. Why don't you see if you can help him in his study of the native problem in this county? That's a good idea.
Now let's see what I need yet. I mean, at least I got dynamite now, so I could do that one part if I can find some. Looks like I need to go play me a little bit of poker. That's not bad. 6-4 on suit.
That's more like.
Problem is that the overturns aren't all that great. See what I can get here.
Hey,
ain't you aggressive, partner?
Son of a bitch!
You got all my chips. At least I got a real kick out of playing.
That's me done.
Okay, that was bullshit. Really? I have that good a goddamn hand. They gotta give some one other guy a hand that's literally just a card better. Fucking dumb. Shit, all I need is a jack. Ten, nine, eight, seven. Missing the six. And I did not get the flush.
A check.
Pocket pair. Yeah, about figures. Jack seven off suit. No. There's just not enough opportunity in that hand to... do anything with it. Holy shit, somebody's got a good opener. Pair of sevens on table. With a jack, and I've got nothing. Ace four, I ain't even trying on that. Losing too much. Fuck no. Table,
I'm gonna check.
But I don't have much in hand to back it, and I don't think I'm quite willing to risk that. Four, five, offsuit, but start of a straight. And that's all I get. I need a six and a seven. Or a six and a three. No, I need a set. I need both that six and that seven. Or that's, yeah, really about it. It's about the only way to make something out of that hand. No. Oh, God, no. I'm not even going to try with that. All right. Betting on a pocket pair. They just... Oh, no. All right. Queen nine, I could do something with that. Especially on suit. need a jack and a, well, no, not even a jack 10 to do me any good. Speaking of a jack, all right, there we go, there we go, there we go. Pair of fours on table with a queen. So a 5-3 or a 5-8, and I'm actually pretty good.
Interesting. You're in. Good.
I'll call that. Ooh-cha-wa-wa. If I can bluff him out. Yes. Oh, jack six offsuit, not even worth it.
Of course.
He's the motherfucker to beat right there. No. Nope, I'm gonna tell you right now, I ain't willing to deal with that hand. Not gonna deal with that? Would you give me something I can fucking work with? For Christ's sake? Alright, now that I can work with. Jack 9 on suit, pair of jacks.
Okay, I'll place a bet.
Watch out!
I'll call that.
I'm out.
There we go. There we go. Oh, 5-3 on suit. Sure. We'll go with that. And speaking of on suit and what's in my hand, see how far he's willing to go on that. No. Queen 3 offsuit, not worth it. That's not worth shit neither. Possible to make something out of that 6-3 offsuit. Pair of sevens on board.
All right. I see.
Six. All right, let's see if he's willing to up the ante a little bit. Pretty confident on this one. And I had good reason. Ariyama! Pokemon in chat. Get those Pokeballs out.
shouldn't. I'm way higher level than you.
I'm not ready to get out yet.
Possible flush coming. Gonna get much out of that.
What the hell?
You bored, chicken? Or you just lost your ball?
Moa now?
You know what? Let's see how high I get this to go early. I got that pair of three sitting in hand. Jack 8 on suit. Wouldn't take a lot to make something out of that mess. Queen Jack 10, 9. So I need a jack, or I need a 10 and a 9 and like a king or 7. I mean, I'm not trying to bluff them, but
always nice to see an old friend.
Ooh, do I want to risk that much on a possible flush that I'm still two cards away from? No, I don't. Oh no. No. Not dealing with that nonsense at all. Go big, go home, all right. 10, 6, and a 3. Impossible flush. Let's go for one more card. Ooh. Not what I was hoping for. Was it terrible to continue betting on that one? I mean, obviously turned out not to be the right call, but holy shit, there is pretty much a guaranteed flush on the board. Why can't I hit the straight when I want it?
I just ain't getting the car.
No. We're out on that. Out on that one, too. Out of... God damn it, give me a hand I can work with. He's cheating. He has to be. It's a stretch, but I could do something with it.
Now we got ourselves a game.
Deal, please, anyone yet? Bet. I know. Sorry, buddy. I think you wanted this one. Deal. I'm out.
Back my money. Oh, hell no. Queen 4 offsuit? No.
I'll raise you.
Call. Well, that's interesting. You be scared now.
Count me in.
I'm eating away at his profits.
I'm gonna check.
Lawman,
it's just a pair of kings.
I'll call that.
Offsuit jack 8. And I ain't gonna get anything out of it. Not taking that risk. Hell no.
You ain't much fun.
On suit, but so far apart. I haven't a hope in hell that flush. We'll take the risk on 20. All right. Slightly higher cards. We'll see what I get out of it. King 10-5. So no flush. Really not much of anything else.
Guess I'm folding.
Always nice to see an old friend.
Oh, he got so lucky on that.
Think I'm gonna call.
All right, ace and a king, so I'm just two cards off from straight. No flush hope. Damn. I needed an eight or a queen. Hell, even a seven would have helped me. 7-8. God damn it.
No thanks.
King 5-6. A definite flush need to be worried about. 7 and a 4, I got something.
Your choice, my friend.
Yeah. No.
I'll talk.
Start of a royal flush. Two cards out, and I'll have nothing. God damn it!
No, I'm out. Call you.
That's something to work with. Six, nine, and a five. So I got a pair of fives and a possible straight.
Watch out. I call.
Three of a kind.
Easy there, cowboy.
You know what? Let's see how far he's willing to go.
I'm gonna raise that.
High roller trophy earned. I won over 2,000 chips in a hand of poker.
Always know when to walk away.
Fall on your knees. Beg for his forgiveness.
Pokemon in chat. Alright, I keep having internet issues, so as much as I don't want to cut this short, I think I just might. I think I just need to reset my damn router.
Sorry for your loss, ma'am. Take care.
Need to do this night patrol deal. Idiots, get out of the goddamn way. at the 4-hour mark. Besides that, then. I'm going to go on ahead and raid this out, because I've been having too many internet issues, or streaming issues. I don't know if it's internet, what the deal is, but I'm going to reset my internet. So y'all be good to yourselves, each other, the planet. Have fun. Stay the fuck out of trouble. Exercise the rights, responsibilities, and privileges of whatever area you happen to be from. As viewers, you know, show that love and respect to the streamers you watch. As streamers, show the love and respect to your viewers, because, I mean, we could do the job without them, but it wouldn't be any fun. All right, this is your Immortal Sith Emperor signing out.